According to a Weibo post, which cites firstpost.com, there might be a new way to conserve the environment. Apparently, scientists have discovered a new method that can convert harmful greenhouse gases into chemicals that can be used to produce synthetic fuels. The process can reduce industrial carbon dioxide emissions by up to 40%. The method was discovered by researchers at the University of Delaware and involves electrochemically converting carbon dioxide into carbon monoxide with 92% efficiency. The carbon monoxide can then be used as an industry feedstock for producing synthetic fuels. Chinese internet users also took note that the project's lead researcher is named Feng Zhao, which many Weibo users concluded was a Chinese scientist working in America. And now let's take a look at what they had to say about this story.
It seems science can solve all our problems. Now, if only they can quickly commercialize this technology, we could save our environment. The lead scientist is a Chinese person. How come nobody in China discovered this technique? Why are all the brilliant Chinese scientists working in America? What does this say about our scientific community? Science and technology have revolutionized the world, and I think this new discovery could also have a huge impact on the planet. China should give priority to the adoption of this new technique. China is the world's biggest carbon dioxide emitter. If China can cut down greenhouse gas by 40%, then that would be a global reduction of at least 10%.
This new discovery could prove to be invaluable to China, since China is currently the world's largest emitter of carbon dioxide, making up more than 23% of global emissions. The U.S. and the European Union are ranked second and third with 18.3% and 14%. However, according to an article from The Guardian, CO2 emissions are being outsourced by rich nations to rising economies. The draft UN report indicates that the majority of greenhouse gases are being produced through coal burning, which is mainly used to power factories in developing countries that produce goods for U.S. and European consumers. The article also points out that there is now growing debate about how to assign responsibility for emissions generated through goods production that were made in one country but ultimately destined for another.